sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game, I'm out of the pocket, but.
From the area known as Patriot Place, EA Sports set for football at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. A moment ago, the pride of Massachusetts, the Patriots, introduced to this, as always, sold-out crowd as they get set to go head-to-head with the Denver Broncos. Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. KJ Hamler returning it. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Griggs. He's got his 6'5 receiver, that's Tim Patrick. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. This defense for the Pats, they were very solid last week in the victory over Baltimore.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Off play action, Griggs. Throw right side, going to be complete to Moss. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
On 1st and 10, Griggs eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's 2nd and 10. They run the counter. Gary. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Play fake. Griggs. And he fires one that's intercepted. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick. And the Patriots are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover. It's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
Meanwhile, Jones' throw pulled in by Woods. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Buying time to his left. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. They'll run with a former member of the Crimson Tide, Damian Harris. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. Throwing, Jones. He finds his man, complete. It's Jones. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
You have to ask the question, where was the help? Because it's a little surprising to me that he'd find that much room to run this close to the end zone. He doesn't quite get there, but he sets his guys up with a first and goal.
First and goal, a chance to convert. Hey, what's going on? Madden.
Harris. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down. So often you hear that pep talks don't really work.
I started watching it today with another teacher. We watch it at lunch. So we're going to watch it at lunch every day for like the next 6 days.
They got a nice stop right there for a loss on first and goal. Second down and goal. Jones. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Been a real good start to this game from a defensive perspective, but now after the incompletion on second down,
when we saw, I saw how long it was. I was like, you sure you want to watch this? We could watch Dancing with Wolves instead, same amount of time.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Now Jones toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
You don't know who it is. I haven't seen her yet. I thought of it. I texted him. I always call him a nerd because he reads a lot and he likes comic books. So I texted him. I was like, hey, you want to come over and watch the Batman with me? And then, like, all of a sudden I saw the dots appearing like he was writing back, you know? And then all of a sudden somebody's knocking on my door and he didn't even send a message back. I was like, I went to open the door. I was like, did you just immediately get up and run over here? What the hell? And he's like, well, yeah. Yeah, the only thing we saw was like the first 15 minutes, and he beat the hell out of those guys, you know, the ones at the beginning.
Yeah. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so it shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick,
yeah.
Look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take
the ball. I mean, the first scene didn't seem so bad, so it's awesome.
Second and two now from the 33.
Yeah.
Operating from the gun. Griggs. Toward the sideline. He will have the
well, I'm going to watch it in six different segments, probably, or so. Might not. Maybe it won't feel that way.
Looking to throw, Griggs going up top, and the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off, and the Pats are going to take over at their own 30-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well, and they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
On first down, Jones. And his throw is incomplete. DeMarcus Robinson, the intended target on that one. And it's second down. You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his footwork. Just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On third down, Jones. Hunter Henry brings it in. And out across midfield, down to the 45.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Good position to be in here, second and inches. On the give, this is Harris. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. And sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though. Huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Jones throw here into the hands of Jones. And they are able
to fucker. Damn it.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
They'll run. Here's Burton, the fullback, trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll try to run with Harris. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Damian Harris, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. Extra point safely through. And the lead grows to 10-0. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Off play action, Griggs. Here's Moss with a catch out of the backfield. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide it. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
To throw on second down, Griggs. That's complete to Moss out of the backfield. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Throwing on first down, Griggs. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. The first down screen pass, good for five.
Boy, that one was well read defensively. And this is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive, because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
Looking to throw on second down, Griggs. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you back down. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
They come up now third and five following the incomplete pass. Back to throw again. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. So giving 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And it'll be fourth down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. Off the play fake. Griggs. They'll roll him out right. Finding the open man, and that's Tim Patrick. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And the defense bit hard there. They were thinking run all the way, play fake, working to perfection on fourth down.
and it was able to work because of the down and distance situation. Fourth and short, you've got to respect the run. You show a little play action, oftentimes you find people open for what you need, and that's exactly what they got done there.
Johnson's got it complete. That catch good for only a couple.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days. But you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target. And that's how he'll shred a defense.
On second down, Gary able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half, 10-0 our score.
What was that?
Jonathan Jones. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. The mistakes continuing to pile up, and it looked like they were going to be able to eat into that deficit. Instead, now the deficit is even larger.
Yeah, they were on a march for the chance to get back within a score, but now that deficit continues to grow.
He's got it, and it's 17-0. Shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. He will return this from deep in the end zone, and no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into his windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
On first and 10, Griggs escaping the pressure right. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Now a play fake here on first down. That's caught by the tight end, Harrison Bryant. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 32
seconds. Yeah, I think that would be a fair adjustment.
first and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Johnson. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Flushed out right. For Charles, in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now...
And that is caught! Touchdown, Denver! Quintez Cephas. As the first half is winding down, and the Broncos are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And it's 17-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks away. On the return, Corey Ballantyne. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And with a two-score lead already, they may just look to get this thing to the locker room. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Looking to throw, Jones, and that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
Right.
I think you've got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. On second down, this is Harris, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. Ballantyne to return. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. At the line, ready to go. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. And a tackle there by Quan Alexander.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Blitz forthcoming as he'll look to throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side
and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
I like what they tried to do there. Tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands, and hope he could make some yards after the catch and pick up a first down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
Ambler now on the return. Great blocking on the return. It springs him for 25. And it'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over first and 10. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. They run the counter. Gary, and they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just not back whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
And nowhere for him to go again. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Play action, Griggs. He gets this complete to Cephas. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. He'll get this one to Patrick. Space to run past the 20. And all the way down to the 5.
What an excellent end result for them. But let's go back to the decision, first of all, to go for it all on fourth down. A lot of pressure on the quarterback's shoulders, but they knew he could handle it. Makes the right read there, gets the ball to his receiver. They get the first down. It's now first and goal.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. A great play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Broncos draw a bit closer.
No, it doesn't.
Extra point.
Could be spotted into a sonar.
But he gets it to go. And the lead is down to a field goal.
It just shows the satellite, doesn't it? Does it say radar?
After the touchdown, here's McManus now.
But if you're spotted, I think it shows you everything. Like, it's not a satellite for radar.
This fielded right at the goal.
Not one. When?
And it's a pretty good return here, so get this up.
I'm saying it's the same thing when you're spotted with radar or sonar. It's different when you're using it. Like, it shows headphones for sonar when it's on your boat. Pretty sure, because I know the symbol for sonar on your boat is the headphones, and the symbol for radar on your boat is the like the dots, like the little blips, you know.
After that last touchdown, as they nurse this small lead, throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys.
No, one of them is headphones.
Saw how precise he was and constructed a defense to try and chip away at that, and thus far they've been successful.
On second down now, it's Harris. And he'll work this one out to about the 38. 55 rushing yards on the ground for him so far.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Harris. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
like I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. Jones on first down. And he'll find his target. Woods, it's complete. Give him nine there on the first down completion. From just shy of midfield, Jones. He finds his man, complete. That's Jones. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 34-yard line.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Here's a run on first down that doesn't accomplish anything. In fact, he's going to be tackled behind the line for a loss of one.
No surprise there, Jadeveon Clowney with a tackle for loss. We all know how he became one of the most famous players in football, though, don't we remember?
Oh, that one play.
Yeah, that one big-time play was on highlights everywhere. They want to see more of that here in the NFL.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the Broncos will take over here at their own 14-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to the win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
There to stop him, Juwan Bentley. Some time right. He finds his man complete. It's Patrick. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
And that's a nice throw right there. And I'll tell you what I've seen in recent times and actually watched a presentation in the offseason from a college offensive coordinator that showed about 10 different drills that he runs with his quarterbacks to show them how to get out of the pocket, how to get comfortable when they're doing so, and to make plays under that type of duress. That's an example of what we're seeing the colleges deliver to the NFL.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A little too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow. And it didn't on that play.
Design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled.
And his passes.
Why the fuck?
4-10 today. Devin McCourty picks it off. And the Patriots are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today. And you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. And that is gonna do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL. On EA Sports. Second down and four. Jones. And, oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. What a difference a week makes. Last week, he hit on over 80% of his passes. This week, he's down under 50%. What do you see as the difference?
Well, I think we're used to seeing a drop. If someone's over 80%, they're not going to hold that number, not in this league. But a drop under 50%, that just tells me that the defense has spent a lot of extra time on game films and came up with a really good plan to try and chip away at his timing.
A big one now, trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. From the gun, Jones, flush to his right. Right side complete, that's Woods. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Boy, that was a big gamble for them right there. They went for it on fourth down, showed a little chutzpah because they did it with the lead here in the fourth quarter. And this defense is once again unable to stop him.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 75 yards rushing for him in the ballgame now on 14 carries. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They run with Harris. Strong run, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. Justin Simmons up from his safety spot to make the tackle.
Now, I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Eluding the pressure right. And that falls to the ground incomplete. Bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down. New England on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 7. Back to throw, Jones. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. The corner blitz pays off there as they sack him for a loss of 5.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question.
We have to tell Cindy to figure out her headset, because every time she's on, I'm just annoyed the entire time with my doc.
If they had scored a touchdown there,
down in the other direction, no. All of a sudden they're down. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line.
I haven't expressed that yet. That's what we should tell her for sure.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And that last turnover could have proven more costly, but their defense only gave up 3. But now answering with a field goal doesn't do them much on this drive. They need to try and find the end zone. Got a man here, it's Brian. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. And I'm going to keep firing.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Off the bootleg. Griggs sliding out of the pocket. Outright, this one goes to Patrick. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He was out there waving his arms. Well, you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help. I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll get it down on the play to the 37.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw, Griggs. And boy, another ill-advised throw there as that will wind up incomplete. Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know what he thinks going on out there, CD.
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. But we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Back to throw. Griggs. Into the hands of Patrick left side. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On first down, Gary. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 58 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll keep it on the ground. Gary, and he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9 yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy? It's a team that's pretty good against the run. What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
Off the play fake, Griggs rolling to his right. They go with a shuffle pass, and it's complete. And he's going to be taken down with the marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Maybe worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's third and long. Looking to throw, Griggs dancing to his, and he is going to be taken down. They got him, and as that is going to take us to the 2 minute warning. Matt Judon in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2 minute warning. So on now is Brandon McManus. He has hit from as far away as 57, but that was in Denver. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. And McManus able to put it through. And that cuts the lead down to just 3, 20-17.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see him take all 3 timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use.
this one in hand.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. They run again with Harris. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now the Broncos are going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. Here comes the blitz as they look to, and he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
He'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. Throw right side, taken in by the tight end, Bryan. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow. Well, we know someone just added to his touchdown passing total, but all he did was get the ball out quickly to his tight end and let him take care of business the rest of the way.
Extra point from McManus is good, and that will make this a four-point game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Valentine to return. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
And they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution to Henry. And some room to roam now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. To throw is Jones. Looking downfield for Jones. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Broncos have just about sewn up this football game. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise.